Hello, you're watching ERi-TV. Welcome to English News Broadcast. These are the major headlines. Seminar organized in Haggas on sexually transmitted diseases. Eritrean national sportsman voluntarily donated blood. The global COVID-19 case and vaccination coverage continue to rise. And Chinese foreign minister visits Turkey as Iran and China signed a 25-year cooperation accord. Local news. Workshop on the prevention of sexually transmitted diseases in general and HIV/AIDS in particular was organized to women in Haggas town. At the workshop, which was conducted from 21st to 23rd of March, a number of issues were raised regarding STDs and prevention mechanisms, including the causes and effects of STDs and AIDS, prevention methods on the treatment of patients and related issues. The main focus of the awareness-raising workshop was to ensure the health of the youth and thereby ensure their future, this according to organizers of the workshop from Bidho National Association. Speaking at the event, Mr. Teklahimanut Musail, Managing Director of Haggas Subzone, stated that commendable outcome is being registered from the STD prevention awareness-raising campaigns as well as efforts being conducted to ensure public health and commended the initiative taken by the association. Similar workshops will be organized in all subzones of the Ansibar region. This is according to further reports. In line with the effort being exerted under the team Donate Blood Save Lives, sportsmen of the national basketball team as well as members of the National Basketball Federation voluntarily donated 23 bags of blood. The sportsmen donated blood at the National Blood Transfusion Center yesterday. Speaking to Arena, the players and members of the National Basketball Federation said it was the first time to donate blood in an organized manner and expressed readiness to augment the blood reserves of the National Blood Transfusion Center. Assistant Nurse Suleiman Berhev from the National Blood Transfusion Center pointed out the significance of voluntary blood donation in saving lives and commended the blood donors. According to the reports from the National Blood Transfusion Center, a total of 224 bags of blood were collected in Asmara from March 20 to 26. The residents of the Arab Alos Gala Nafhi subzone are conducting popular water and soil conservation campaigns. The popular campaign includes construction of water diversion schemes and terraces. According to reports from the subzone, the water and soil conservation they conducted is expected to contribute to redressing the environment and thus boost agricultural products. A training program on controlling vegetables and crops disease has been also organized by the Ministry of Agriculture branch in the subzone to about 30 farmers in the Arab Alos. A similar training program have also been organized to farmers in various administrative areas and the subzone. Now back with international news after a short break. Welcome back. The total number of confirmed COVID-19 cases globally surpassed 127 million today, with the deaths still exceeding 2.7 million. And the number of recovered patients has exceeded 102 million, this according to data from World Meters. The United States has surpassed 30.8 million confirmed cases of COVID-19 today. Brazil surpassed 12.4 million cases, and India has recorded nearly 12 million cases, respectively. The World Health Organization has called for countries and companies worldwide to immediately share 10 million doses of COVID-19 vaccines with the United Nations-backed COVAX scheme to deliver jabs to poorer nations. COVAX, an international platform aiming to deliver 2 billion doses to the world's poorest countries within the year, has often criticized high-income countries for having secured the vast majority of limited supplies of vaccines, contributing to a stark and even distribution of shots. And in China, rather in France, the number of patients with coronavirus in intensive care units rose today to the highest level this year. This according to the country's health ministry, as the government faced calls for strict lockdown to curb the third wave of infections. France has already registered a total of 4.4 million COVID-19 cases. Turkey's foreign minister Mevlüt Cavusoglu and his Chinese counterpart Wang Yi met in the Turkish capital Ankara. After holding a 1-1 meeting with the Chinese Foreign Minister, Shanzhu Zoghulu said Ankara would like to see Chinese President Xi Jinping visit Turkey and that the two countries take their relations to a level of strategic partnership. Meanwhile, Iran and China have signed a 25-year cooperation accord as both countries remain under United States sanctions. The agreement was signed in Tehran today by Iran's Foreign Minister Mohammad Javad Zarif and China's Foreign Minister Wang Yi. Wang, who arrived in Tehran yesterday for a two-day visit as part of his Middle East trip, also met with President Hassan Rouhani and Ali Rajani, a representative of the Supreme Leader Ali Hossani Khamenei, who is said to have been the point person of the 25-year accord. The agreement is said to have been in the works since Chinese President Xi Jinping visited Iran in 2016, also agreeing to increase bilateral trade more than tenfold to $600 billion in the next decade. Two trains collided in southern Egypt, apparently after someone activated the emergency brakes, killing at least 32 people and leaving 108 injured. The collision caused three passengers' cars to flip over, and videos on the local media from the scene showed wagons with passengers trapped inside and surrounded by debris. Some victims seemed unconscious, while others could be seen bleeding. Bystander carried bodies and laid them out on the ground near the site. Egypt's railway authority said the trains collided after emergency brakes were triggered by unknown individuals near the city of Sohag, about 500 kilometers south of the capital, Cairo. Egypt has one of the oldest and largest railway networks in North Africa, and accidents causing casualties are common. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.